I think screen printing is both an art form and a production technique. Because like, if you're doing a poster and you want to like put different elements down, you can get really creative. But then also it's a way to, you know, put all this production out there. Like you can just take an image, burn it, and print as many as you want. And it's always going to be the same exact image.
This is kind of like my version of chopping wood. The original design came from a photo that I took, and then I just went at it with a Sharpie and a whiteout pen and just created this kind of like, you know, ultra contrasty image. But then after making the posters and after, you know, getting better at silkscreening and things like that, I realized that I wanted it to be the same every single time. So then I went ahead and created like a vector image of it that's like the exact same width, the exact same height, like just so it's exactly the same every single time. Silkscreening just offers a much cleaner version of a stencil. And it allows me to make a lot of images for not a lot of money. So I like that part about it. And I think it's cool, it has that kind of, you know, DIY aspect to it.
I think a lot of people had brought out screens, but I have never seen anybody do silk screening kind of the way that we do. So this is the latest prototype we've made. We've taken a normal press and kind of just distilled down, maybe even dumbed it down, because most presses are really big and heavy and not portable at all. So that's the reason that silk screening was not really done in the public forum so much. A lot of people had heard of silkscreening, or they had owned a silkscreen shirt or a silkscreen poster or something, but they didn't really understand how silkscreening was done. And there we were, right at the middle of this party, making shirts. And it was just as much entertainment of watching, you know, us make shirts as it was about getting a shirt. I used to say that everybody is an artist, and I kind of think that, but I do believe that everybody is an art director. You know, everybody knows what they like and what they don't like, and people might not become ultimate creators of the perfect graphics that are in their head or that they like or things like that, but I think that they're is a better appreciation of arts that way.
My name's Andrew Holder. I am an illustrator artist person, and we are in my studio. My screen printing is pretty much my fine art. I do that intentionally, like that's what I'm trying to do with my prints. I'm not trying to make a thousand prints, and it's not a big commercial thing. It's just my way of presenting what I do. And I do smaller batches, I think, for that reason. It makes each one a little more special, you know, even though there are like probably 30 of them out there. My dad came over, and he didn't know anything about screen printing. He was just helping me out. And I showed him what I was going to be printing. He's like, oh, it looks really good. It looks great. I love it. And about 2 hours into it, he puts one down, and he's like, oh, now I get it. Like, he was just, he just liked it just because I did it, but then he finally saw what it actually was. It was, the image is actually in what I didn't print, so it's like, the, you know, the negative space, and then just kind of all of a sudden, it just flips.
I'm Mike from Two Rabbits. Welcome to the Scum Dungeon. I mean, a lot of the designs have to do with the band, you know, the music, how much we like the band, how busy we are. It just depends, you know, what's coming up. Like, there's some bands that we'll do work for and we instantly know what we should do. And then other things, it's kind of like, how do we figure this out? What's their new music like? What's their new art like? How can we resemble that in some way? So everything I use gets recycled and redone. I don't really throw anything away. I figure out a new way to like incorporate it. I'm constantly like this. I'm gonna destroy it, print over it, and make it something new. Recycled, nothing goes to waste type artwork.
It was just cool to be able to put, you know, something that you liked onto like a walking, you know, like a t-shirt. It's a walking billboard for people. So we always liked that idea.
Our product exceeded more than a million prints already. If you have a 100-piece order that has four colors, then they're, you know, to the customer, it's 100 shirts. But for us, it's 400 times we have to swipe it. You know, the customer only say, oh, that's just one print, one logo.
Before we got automatic on both posters and t-shirts, if we had 3,000 shirts to print, we had our very dedicated printer in here printing for like 12 hours.
Day and night, I mean, it was nonstop.
And then we automated it and, you know, we'll walk in and all of a sudden he'll, you know, the 2,500 shirts that needed to be done, are they're done. And he's not fatigued, he's not tired. This morning we printed about
2,000 posters.
2,000 posters before lunch.
That would have taken a week before hand printed. I mean, it's just, it's a different world with being automatic on stuff. But that doesn't always mean it's gonna be better. Sometimes the hand printed process will have better results than an automatic one.